Hello students, welcome back. In the previous class, we have discussed the levels of biodiversity, that is genetic diversity, species diversity and ecological diversity. In this class, we will be starting with the species diversity on Earth. You got the definition for species diversity. So now, we are discussing the species diversity on Earth. As there are published records of how many number of species have been recorded so far, and we know that how many number of species in all have been recorded so far, but we have no idea, or it is not very easy to answer the question, that is, how many number of species are there on the earth, isn't it? We know some number of species which have been recorded, but we have no idea of how many number of species are there on the earth. But according to IUCN, it is the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. So according to this IUCN, the total number of plant and animal species which are described so far, it is slightly more than 1.5 million. So it is according to IUCN, according to IUCN, the total number of plant and animal species which are described so far, it is slightly more than 1.5 million. And we have no idea about how many number of species are yet to be discovered. There might be about 6 million of species are waiting to be discovered and described. It is just an estimation. So they will say that there might be about 6 million species are waiting to be discovered and described. So it is just an estimation, and these estimates, they vary widely, and most of them are educated guesses. It is just guess, and it is not exactly recorded so far. And certain extreme estimates ranges from 20 to 50 million. So these are the extreme estimates, is about 20 to 50 million. But it is also not a conservative. The more conservative and scientifically sound estimate made by a scientist named as Robert May. So Robert May, he made a scientifically sound estimate, and he places the global species diversity about 7 million. So according to IUCN, it is about 1.5 million, and many number of species are yet to be discovered. There might be about 6 million. It is an estimation, and extreme estimates about 20 to 50 million, but it is not a conservative. The more conservative and scientifically sound estimate made by Robert May, and according to him, the global species diversity is about 7 million. And most of the species which are waiting to be discovered are usually at the region of tropics. Now, let us discuss some interesting aspects of Earth's biodiversity based on the currently available inventories, species inventory. Based on the currently available species inventories, let us look at the Earth's biodiversity. So, you know, there are 1.5 million of species or 7 million of species. So, overall, all these are the estimates, but overall, all the species which are recorded, out of that, 70% are animals. So, out of the total species, 70% are animals. Or we can say more than 70% are animals, and only 22% are not more than 22% are plants, including algae, fungi, mosses, mosses means bryophytes, and gymnosperms, angiosperms, etc. So try to remember. So overall, all the species recorded so far, out of that, 70% are animal. More than 70% are animals, and only 22% are about plants. And another interesting thing is that out of the total animals, So there are 70% animals, and out of the total animals, again 70% are insects. 70% are insects. So in overall species, 70% are animals, and in the total animals, again 70% are insects. Which means out of every 10 animals, 7 are insects. So the number of insects are more worldwide, because out of all the animals, 70% are insects. If you take 10 animals, out of 10 animals, 7 will be the insects. So that is again important. And the total number of fungal species in the world, which is more than the total number of vertebrate species. See, for example, if you look at this pie chart, so these are the vertebrates. The number of vertebrates, you can consider an estimate ranges. But the total number of fungal species in the world, which is more than the overall vertebrate species. Now, look at the chart. See, this is the representation of invertebrate species. As I said, so these are the animals. Out of all the animals, here you can observe 70% are insects. 70% are insects, and remaining you can observe molluscans, crustaceans, and other animal group. So this is one pie chart representation. And when we look at the vertebrate species, here the number of species are more, and mammals, amphibians are of same number, and birds, reptiles are of same percentage. So this is one representation. And the representation, pie chart representation of plants, when you observe this one, the number of fungal species and number of flowering plants will be more in number. So you can observe here, the percentage of fungi and flowering plants will be more in number, and mosses, ferns, they are less in percentage, even algae and very least number of organisms are lichens. But the fungal species are more when compared to overall vertebrate species. And here, scientists have not shown the pie chart for microbial species or prokaryotic organisms, because biologists are not sure about how many number of prokaryotic species are there. Because the conventional taxonomic methods are not suitable for identifying the microbial species, because most of the microbial species cannot be simply cultured under laboratory conditions. Only if we consider the biochemical and molecular criteria. When we consider the biochemical and molecular criteria, the number of microbial species may run into millions. If we consider the biochemical and microbial criteria, the number of microbial species will run into millions. So this is the species diversity of Earth. And these are the representation. Now we see the species diversity in India. Species diversity in India. Yeah, in India, when we look at the land area around the world, so India having about 2.4% land area. India having only 2.4% of the world's land area. And India contains about 8.1% of global species diversity. So in India, it contributes about 8.1% of global species diversity. Due to this percentage, India, it is one of the global mega biodiversity country. So it is one of the mega biodiversity country. And why it is considered as one of the mega biodiversity country? Because of this percentage of global species diversity in India. Because the land area is very small. Even though it is having a less land area, but the global species diversity is more. That's why India is one of the mega biodiversity country. And in India, we can find about 45,000 plant species and twice as many number of animal species, that is approximately 90,000 species of animals have been recorded in India. So 45,000 species of plants and 90,000 species of animals have been recorded in India. But according to Robert May, according to Robert May's global estimate, only 22% of them, or 22% of the total, have been recorded so far, and remaining percentage has yet to be discovered. Only 22% is discovered so far, but remaining percentage are yet to be discovered. When we apply this proportion, so according to Robert May, only 22% of the total have been recorded. When we apply this proportion to India's diversity, in India about 1 lakh plant species and 3 lakh animal species are yet to be discovered. So we are just applying the May's criteria or May's proportion. So as he said, only 22% are recorded, remaining are yet to be discovered. So in India, 45,000 species plants and 90,000 species of animals have been recorded, and according to May's proportion, remaining about 1 lakh plant species and 3 lakh animal species are yet to be discovered. And we cannot predict that when this inventory of biological diversity or searching for the species diversity will complete, because as we know, many number of species are yet to be discovered, and many of them are extinct even before we discover them. So some species are yet to be discovered, and even some species are already extinct even before we discover them. And here, whatever the plant and animal species which are there on the earth, in the nature, so all those species are compared to books in the library of nature. So the entire nature is compared to a library, and whatever the plant, animal species and remaining species which are discovered so far are compared to books. So in the nature's biological library, many species are discovered and many of the species are yet to be discovered. So this is about the species diversity on earth and species diversity in India. So next we can observe the patterns of biodiversity, everything in the next class. So this percentage of plant and animal species is very, very important. So based on these, you may get any questions about the percentage or the number of species. So this completes the species diversity. Now we will discuss few objective questions related to the today's class. See, with the first question, in our biosphere, immense diversity or heterogeneity exists at option A, species level, option B, genetic level, option C, all levels of biological classification, and option D, all of the above. So here we can observe the immense diversity, that is heterogeneity, at all levels, even at species level, genetic level, and at biological classification. So option D, all of the above, is correct. Next, second question, term biodiversity was popularized by option A, Paul Hillrich, option B, David Tillman, option C, Edward Wilson, option D, Robert May. So option C is correct, Edward Wilson. And third question, the most important components of biodiversity are option A, genetic diversity, option B, species diversity, option C, ecological diversity, and option D, all of the above. Here, all are the components of biodiversity. So option D is correct. And fourth question, which of the following is mismatched pair? Option A, genetic diversity, genus level, species diversity, species level, ecological diversity, ecosystem level, and option D, none of the above. Here, option A is actually the mismatched pair, because genetic diversity, in the sense at gene level, we are observing the variations at gene level but not at genus level, but remaining are correct. Species diversity at species level and ecological diversity at ecosystem level, but genetic diversity is at gene level but not at genus level. And remaining questions are home assignment for you. and this completes today's class.